Well, good evening, and sorry for the change of schedule. Very happy to be here in Zagreb to say a few words about how France promotes its cultural content. It works. Well, let's begin by cinema and audiovisual. We have a primary tool, the French National Center for Cinema, Centre National du Cinéma, CNC, created in 1946, both a public body and a professional organization. It supports cinema in various ways: direct financial support to film for production, distribution, and exhibition, and financing structure supporting audiovisual and cinema activities, Cinema School or UniFrance that promotes French cinema abroad. We also have tax measures. The originality of the French cinema and audiovisual support policy system is the low direct state budgetary contributions. Financial support schemes are essentially financed internally through a compulsory tax obligation for cinemas, broadcasters, video and VOD publishers, as well as internet service providers to nourish the French National Center for Cinema budget. We have the special additional tax levied on each cinema ticket. We have a broadcaster tax, 5.5% of their income, a video VOD tax, 2% of their income, and ISPs are also contributors since 2008 in their capacity of TV service providers, 5.6% of their ad income, and also TAT credits for cinema and audiovisual producers. So firstly, the CNC, secondly, tax measure, thirdly, TV broadcaster obligation in French and European works financing. It usually takes the form of broadcasting rights, pre-sales, and co-production support. Terrestrial, cable, and satellite TV channels are concerned, 3.2% of the turnover, of which 75% dedicated to independent cinema. Special treatment for Canal Plus, our pay TV channel, 20% of its turnover. Broadcasting quotas complete this scheme. 60% of TV channels programming shall be dedicated to European works, of which 40% only for works in original French language. Regions and local collectivity also play a crucial role through logistic, technique, and human resources support when hosting a shooting location. So let's talk about books now. We have mainly economic measure through a fixed price system for books provided in 1981 law, a long act named from Jack Lang, the famous Minister of Culture of François Mitterrand. So we have price fixed by the publisher or importer for all kind of books, be they French or not. The objective is to preserve a wide network of bookshops. And the fact that books are not like any other commercial goods and such scheme leads to a greater diversity in the book offer. And we also have an adapted tax scheme, a reduced VAT rate to 5.5%. instead of 20% for main products. So let's talk about my favorite one, French policy support for music, with a focus on radio quotas. The 1994 law provides the only legal provision regulation music offer by requiring French radio stations to play a certain proportion of songs in French. Not French songs, but songs in French. Radio stations are required to broadcast a minimum of 40% of songs in French, language, half of which should come from new talents or recent production during prime times. A derogatory regime is provided for radio stations specialized in musical heritage promotion, where 60% of the work shall be in French language, but only 10% from new talents. Radio stations specialized in the promotion of young talents, where only 35% of songs are in French language, while 25% at least shall be new songs in total. Such system exists all over the world, and it's a good and effective system because you only listen what you hear, and we know that even young public, which spends most of its time on internet, is still very influenced by what it broadcasted on radio. That's why the radio quotas are so important for us. So such a system exists in Australia, where we invented first such a quota scheme in its local artist in 1942. Quebec has a very protective radio quota system, such as South Africa. And in Europe, Portugal, Norway, Slovenia have also implemented such system. Of course, this system showed perverse effects because some of the big commercial radios simply bombard their audience with 10 same French-speaking songs all the daytime, which causes double sentence for French-speaking artists, less exposure on radio and less diversity. That's why in 2016, a few months ago, a new bill of law on creation, freedom, heritage, and architecture threatens the radio quota scheme. Under the pressure of commercial radios, there were a proposal to weaken and lower the percentage of French language songs. But thanks to the mobilization of the French music sectors and its artists, the proposal has evolved, but not weakened the mechanism. So, this is the system now. So, very, very French, quite complicated. But the inputs of the new law are, firstly, a new special regime described in the blue squares in the picture, with a new category of radio stations included in the scheme, radio stations specialized in music discovery, broadcasting at least 1,000 different songs each month, of which 50% are new songs. And each song is broadcasted maximum 100 times a month. And at least 50% of new talents and or new French-speaking production. A rotation cap in the fourth column. If the top 10 represent more than 50% of the French-speaking song broadcasted, any song program above this cap will not be contained into the quotas. So radios. Commercial radios can continue bombard the new, same song all day long, but it will not be taken into account anymore. There is also a problematic modulation scheme where the square is. Main quota reduced with a 5 points limit in the station commits to more diversity in its programming. But such commitment is not quantified in the law. Number of broadcasted work, number of artists programmed, diversity in production, diversity, number of time, day, hour a song can be broadcast, and commitment assessed only by the CSA, the French Broadcast Media Regulator. So we'll have to lobby the French Broadcast Regulator to keep a good regulation with this new rose square. But we know that diversity is an everyday fight. So, as a conclusion, I can say that in France we have quite strong cultural industries with something like 1.2 million of jobs. So I can say that it is quite an efficient regulation that we are happy to promote in Europe. Thank you very much.